You're looking there. Police questioning George Zimmerman. Here's what we know at this hour. Shelley Zimmerman called police right around 2:10 p.m. Eastern time. She told police that Zimmerman was threatening her family and had hit her father once in the face. Police say there was a gun present, but it is not clear if a gun was actually used in the alleged threats. All of this happening at the home of Shelley Zimmerman's father, where George and Shelley had been living. Now, Zimmerman's attorney, Mark O'Mara, says Shelley was in the process of moving out and they were dividing their belongings. You will remember, of course, Shelley Zimmerman filed for divorce last week. Now, separating those belongings, Mark O'Mara said that some sort of altercation occurred after heightened emotions. I want to bring in the legal dream team, Tanya Miller, Joey Jackson, to get a little perspective on this. You guys, what would you be doing right now if you were Mark O'Mara? You must be in full damage control. Tanya?
Well, I mean, I would be, if I was able to, obviously come to the scene. I would want to be there with George Zimmerman as he was being questioned by law enforcement, or I would be telling George Zimmerman to stop answering questions until I got there, or stop answering questions, period. I mean, look, O'Mara is not a public relations expert. He's not a PR guy. You know, he's his defense attorney. So how this looks in the public, that's another matter. As far as representing him on the potential criminal charges, I would be telling him to be quiet.
Yeah, good point. Joey Jackson, there were reports that Shelley and her father were refusing to give sworn statements. Does that surprise you?
You know, it's a matter of whether or not they want to press forward and have the case actually heard in court and for there to be a trial that proceeds. It may very well be that they're trying to resolve this now. In terms of advising Zimmerman to be quiet, I think that may fall on deaf ears. We know he likes to speak, just not at trials. But in any event, there are a lot of allegations here, as we know, based upon that 911 call, right? Assault is one of them, criminal mischief for damaging the property, menacing with respect to his gun, were there any threats made? But there's also a credibility issue here, of course, because it's his wife. There's a proceeding that's going to follow. That's a divorce. And, of course, the witness is her dad. And so the police could be problematic moving forward with those two and not an independent, objective witness who has no horse in the race.
Yeah, but look, Lynn, I mean, whenever you have domestic situations like this, oftentimes there will not be an independent person who has no horse in the race
right there.
So what these officers need to do, if they are doing an investigation, is listen to that 911 tape and see if the evidence there on the scene is corroborated. Is there an iPad that's broken? Where is the switchblade or the knife that Shelley referenced
was
in the 911 call?
Was her father's face hit?
Was his face hit?
Yeah.
Are there photographs being taken of that? Are his glasses on the floor like she reported? There are things that the police can do, absent having that independent third party, to try to verify whether or not this actually happened.
Well, and if you're just tuning in, Joey Jackson and Tanya Miller both referencing that 911 call where Shelley Zimmerman said on the call, he has his hands on his gun. He's threatening us. He hit my dad in the nose, smashed my iPad with a pocket knife. I don't know what he's capable of. That's straight from the 911 call.